Hi everyone, welcome back to the Astro Room, your very own portal to the cosmos. Now we will cover the following burning questions in this video. Have you ever wondered where can I go near my own home for darker skies? How do I know what the light pollution level is of where I actually live? Or what is the Bortle scale in my neighborhood? Well, you're in for a surprise because the Seestar app has all of this right in it. And it's easy to use and user-friendly. So let's go. Now, before we dive into these tips and tricks, I want to thank all of you for your support. My next goal is to reach at least 500 subscribers. So if you think I'm providing you with valuable content, please like and subscribe, as this only helps the Astro Room channel to continue making more videos and better content. All right, let's get to it. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is you're going to look at these icons that are down here at the bottom, and you're going to click on the one that's called Nearby. Nearby. We're going to click on that, and this is what you're going to see. You're going to see a map of the whole world, which shows the Seestar community. So you can literally look at all the people that have a Seestar and that are imaging. This is pretty live, I would say, where if you click on one, you're gonna see how long ago they posted, which could have been a minute ago, you know, an hour ago, a day ago. It's very, very interesting. So you can play around with that, see other people's images. And in reality, all of that, right, goes into the community tab or icon that's down here, right? If you click on the community icon, you're gonna get to see everyone who's uploading images to that tab or to that community area. So very, very interesting. Now, when we look at this map, we see that you can find your location, obviously, of where you live, right? And see the people that are also around you that are imaging. Now, let's say you're trying to figure out how dark your skies are. What is the light pollution scale in my area, or literally anywhere around the world? Well, this is really interesting, everyone. If you click on LP map, you see this icon right here. We're going to click on that and check out what happens. So this is your light pollution map now, right? And if you see down here, they have a light pollution level. We can open that up. Click on this little arrow right here. And notice how it gives you your light pollution level from excellent dark sky to inner city sky, which is where I live. I live in city sky pretty much. But if you look at this, this is basically the Bortle scale. This is 1 through 9 right here. So I live at an 8. Pretty much. And of course, the darker skies where you live, or the darker skies where you can get to, the more and more better your images are going to be. And if you live in a not very dark location, I would definitely suggest to use this map. Go in, find locations that are darker near you, where you can go and image and test it out. And I can guarantee you your images are going to be way, way, way better. And one way you'll know is that you can compare by clicking on people who do live in those darker skies. Now, I'll show you guys all of this in a minute, but I don't want to forget to show that if you notice here, what helps indicate how well your skies are, or how dark, right, how far away from light pollution you are. It's got the little level here is comparing it to the M33 galaxy, which is a triangulum galaxy. So basically, of course, in excellent dark skies, the triangulum galaxy, or M33, is going to look clear. It's going to look perfect, right? As we go down the Bortle scale, you know, you've got rural skies, and it's going to be easier to image, right? Then it's going to obviously it gets more and more difficult. As you can imagine, where I am, city sky, it's not the greatest, right? But still amazing that no matter how bad your light pollution is, you can still image some incredible stuff. So now let's get to it. I'm going to close this out real quick, and we're going to see how, like I mentioned, this turned into a light pollution map, right? And let's say you live in Texas. Okay, just an example. We're going to go down toward Texas. I'm going to go to the search feature. This is really cool, guys. So if you go to the search feature, it asks, where do you want to shoot? And let's say I want to check Houston, Texas, and I want to check how dark the skies there are. We know this is an inner city, and that's okay, but I'm using this as an example. When I click on Houston, it'll take you straight there. And look at this. Look at the Bortle scale on this. Look at the light pollution level on here. Obviously, the color is very bright here. It's a grayish white. So yeah, that's, you know, you're gonna get you're still gonna get your images. Look at this. These are people who are posting their images, and you can click on them to look at it, right? See how it looks. You're still gonna obviously be able to image. But as you notice, when you continue to zoom out of this map, you're gonna see different shades of colors of the light pollution level. As in, the closer that we're getting down to number one, the better and better your images are going to be. Okay, so, and for all of you who live in areas that are like this, right, because you can look up where you are exactly, right, check if you go to a darker site, even if you drive an hour or two out, and you're right at the middle, you know, you get to Bortle skies that are right here in the green section, I'm telling you already, your images will be better, for sure. I have seen images online of other Seestar users who live and just cut it down halfway. I live in a Bortle 8, like I said. Let's say they live in a Bortle 4, and their images of some galaxies are just phenomenal. Just incredible. I wish I could get those images, but, you know, here we are. But anyway, so yeah, you can find, you know, obviously anything in the blue down here, even better, right? But yeah, it's really neat how you can see other people's pictures and everything. See how good their images are, those that do live in darker skies. And that's how you can kind of prove it or test it out, right? And we're going to continue zooming out. So that's how you can find out what your Bortle level, what your Bortle scale is. We're just going to do another example. Let's go to Europe. Let's do London. London, UK. Here we are, inner city. And look at that. This is amazing. Look at how many people in the UK have a Seestar. Look at this, everyone. This is amazing. Matter of fact, if I zoom in out a lot, I was noticing earlier today that I think just for London, it's got over 1,000. Yeah, that's it. So it's got like over 1,000 people just in that area. But it's really interesting. So even if you super zoom it out, you've got people that are in tremendous dark skies. Look at this. What is this? Greenland? One person there. This is incredible. So and we can click on, right, his images and look at it. They are in very, very dark skies. They have perfect skies there. So must be amazing. Must be nice. But yeah, these are the tips and tricks I wanted to show you guys. A lot of people just don't know, right? A lot of people don't dig into the app, and maybe they don't realize because we're so busy imaging and we're so excited stacking images and going to the next object and things like that, that we forget there's other really neat things in the app to help us continue having fun with the Seestar. So yeah, check it out. See if your images are in here, which I'm sure they are. If you've uploaded any to your community tab, like I said, the community tab that's down here, your images are going to be up here, and also perhaps your neighbor. Maybe you're wondering if your neighbor has a Seestar, you know, or anyone that lives really, really near you. You can find that out. Now, I will say, when I checked my location, I said I live in Southern California, but when I checked my location and exactly where I am, I noticed that it's not 100% accurate. Like, it's not right on me. So it's a few miles out of the way. So, you know, if anyone's worried about, oh, someone's going to know exactly where I am, I really, you know, you can't obviously go to someone's home with the exact picture where it is. If you click on it, it's not 100%. And I do have mine on, my location always on under my settings. My location is always on, constantly on. You know, even if I upload, I am on the community tab as well as Astro Room, and I upload. You can't find, if you try to click on my images and you see where I live, it's actually not 100% accurate, but I would say it comes close, but still impossible to find exactly my home, my location, right? My exact address, because it doesn't show 100% accuracy. It's actually many miles, I would say, even in a different town name, I would say, which I think is good, you know, for one, right? That you don't know exactly where someone is. But yeah, that's it, everyone. I hope you enjoyed these tips and tricks, and feel free to always come back for more. I'm going to have more tips for all of you. And it's only here in the Astro Room. Make sure you like, make sure you subscribe. That's going to keep supporting this channel, and it's going to help me continue making more content and better content for all of you out there. Thank you so much, everyone.